Hello everyone, in this video we are going to solve problem number 45 from chapter Stress Transformation, which is chapter number 9 in the book of Mechanics of Materials by R.C. Hibbeler. In this problem we are given with this current state of stress on an element, and we are being asked to calculate the stress components acting on inclined plane AB. And this problem is same as that of number 4 problem, but this number 45 is to be solved using Mohr circle. So let's solve this problem. So in order to solve this problem, we should be knowing the conditions of stresses at different phases. Like at this phase, we have normal stress of 90 MPa and shear stress of 35 MPa. Now 90 is tensile, and we usually count tensile as positive, and we usually count clockwise shear stress as positive. So this will be the state of stress at this plane. Now how about this plane, where we are having tensile stress of 50 MPa hence positive, but anti-clockwise shear stress of 35 hence negative. So this is the state of stress. So let's draw the Mohr circle. For that we will be having the normal and shear axis. The horizontal is the normal stress and the vertical is the shear stress. In order to have better understanding, let's draw the grid. And let's say that we are having a grid in which one unit is equal to 10 MPa. So let's shift these two points on the normal and shear axis. Let's first shift 90 and 35, 90 positive, hence rightward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 over here, and 35 positive, hence upward, 1, 2, 3 and in between 3 and 4, 35, this will be the point, 90 and 35. The other point, 50 and 35, 50 positive, hence rightward, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 35 is negative, hence downward, over here, 50 and 35, minus 35 actually. So joining these two points, we will be having the diameter of the Mohr circle, and once we will be having the diameter, then we can draw the Mohr circle, because this will be the center of the Mohr circle and this will be the radius, so we can easily draw the Mohr circle. So therefore this will be the Mohr circle for this state of stress. We should be calculating some basic points in a Mohr circle. The first one is the center. Center, if you look at the grid, it will be of 70 MPa, but you can also calculate the average of the normal stresses of these two points, 90 and 50. So it will be actually 140 divided by 2, which will be 70 MPa. So this is the center of the Mohr circle. And if you want to calculate the radius of the Mohr circle, that you can also calculate using this right angle triangle. This perpendicular distance is 35 and this horizontal distance, where the total is 90, this one is 70, so remaining will be then 20. So 35 is perpendicular, base is 20 with respect to this angle. Then using the Pythagoras theorem, we will be having radius as 40.31 MPa. Now we are being asked to calculate the stress component that are acting on an inclined plane AB. Now how to tackle this kind of problem? You can see this AB making an angle of 60 degree with this plane. If you look closely, then this AB plane makes an angle of 30 degree with this plane, and this plane having magnitude of 90 and 35 is represented by this line of radius on the Mohr circle. So it means we have to move this plane in anti-clockwise direction by an angle of 30 degree. So this is the real angle, but if you are in Mohr circle, so then it will be doubled. So instead of 30, we will be having 60 on the Mohr circle. We are going to have the line which will be making an angle of 60 degree with this. So this will be the line telling us about the state of stress at AB plane. We don't know this angle yet, but using this right angle triangle we can calculate. Using tan theta, perpendicular is 35, base is 20, we will be having angle as 60.31 to 5. Therefore, this total angle will be 60 plus 60.25, hence 120.25. So this remaining angle would then be 180 minus 120.25, hence that will be 59.75. So this angle is 59.75. So consider this right angle triangle in order to have the state of stress at this plane. So in this right angle triangle, the perpendicular would be this, the shear stress at AB plane, and then can be calculated considering sine theta formula. So sine 59.75 degrees is equal to perpendicular, which is shear stress at AB plane, divided by the radius, which is 40.31. So from here we will have shear stress at AB 34.8 MPa. How about the normal stress? And that can be calculated if we know the base of this right angle triangle. Let's say the base of this right angle triangle is x. So cos 59.75 is equal to x upon radius hypotenuse, which is 40.31. So from here we will have x as 20.31 MPa. Since the distance up to center is 70 MPa, so if we want to know the normal stress at this point, which is on the plane AB, so it means we are moving backward, it means it should be deducted from the center. So then normal stress at AB plane would be 70 MPa minus x, which is 20.31. So on doing calculations, we will have value as 49.69 MPa. So we just have calculated the normal stress and the shear stress, which is the state of stress at AB plane. So the value of shear stress is positive 34.8 MPa. It means it will be clockwise shear stress at AB plane, and normal stress is positive 49.69, which means it will be a tensile type of normal stress. So this is all from this video, where we have learned how we can calculate the state of stress at any required plane using the Mohr circuit. That's all from this video. Thank you for watching this video.